certified 139 only for CIS market. That's why we discussed with our Italian partners how to make it more attractive for Russian market, this product, to increase volume of sales, because it's only one or two helicopters assembled per year. But we're discussing, we try to find a possible solution of this, and our Italian partners are supporting us in this case.
Can you tell us a bit about the pressure that you might have with import substitution?
Sorry, about?
The pressure that you're facing for things like import substitution to ensure that everything is in Russia. How is that affecting the conversations that you have with customers?
First of all, when we negotiate with our foreign partners, yes, of course, we're talking about the restrictions and if they may supply or not. And the main answer is yes, of course, they are not. They are ready to supply for civil helicopters. For military helicopters, during the previous 4 years, we substituted most of components of these helicopters with not ourselves, with our suppliers, engines, DPU, some components, and so on and so on.
Not all parts.
Not all, yes, of course, not all, but
so
we are in the process now.
We're still reliant on foreign partners.
I don't remember exactly, but for example, PAL system, they didn't deliver their anti-dust systems for MI-2028, and we replaced it, and we developed our own system, and we produced it, we installed it. In my opinion, they could. We couldn't save the market for this. Yes, of course, we understand that they are not their decision. This is a government decision. But we have to produce helicopters. That's why we have to make more active or proactive in this case. That's why we develop the directions with Russian suppliers mostly. But inside of our design, we have capabilities and possibilities to develop our own systems. Yes, of course, sometimes it costs money, but we understand that how we will return it.
Money and time. These customers might not like the time.
Yes, but it's much better than to wait somebody.
Are you working on electrical power and solution?
Yes, we work. You know that in Russia there are institutes of aviation industry, like CEAM, which is responsible for engines and gearbox. And we cooperate with Russian institute to develop, not ourselves, but the engine company to develop a combined system and new electrical system. But R&D, in the course of R&D. But we think about it and we developed it, not we. Russia developed the system. Russian companies. And if you visited Max show in the pavilion of Russian Institutes of Aviation, they presented their new ideas and test engines in this case, some components.